Hello and welcome.
Good night, Pastor.
Good evening.
It's so good to have you and to see your faces. Those of you whom I can see, it's really, really nice. I always miss you. You know, to see you one Sunday a week is not fair. So every chance I get to see you, good people of God, it's always a great blessing. And tonight, we are blessed by the presence of our own Minister Janelle Gale. She will be assisting me with technology on the background. She will manage all the music. And there we go that way.
Amen.
And so eventually Sister Yolande might be able to also join in, and she will be our backup on technology should we need any of her help. You know, this technology is really something, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. I am so grateful for technology. From the moment the pandemic hit us, had we not had technology, I have no idea what would have happened. Because of technology, we were able to worship God and do some level of business of God and continue to strengthen each other's heart. So kudos to technical people. Now, this is going to be a great night.
It is
a great night already.
Mm-hmm.
God has brought us thus far along the day. And I know that God will not leave us or forsake us. We have come to call on God's holiness, to worship God and to praise God, and to just celebrate the goodness of God.
Amen.
That pleases our hearts. And we also bring specific prayer concerns to present them to God as we gather together as the body of Christ in prayer tonight. And so we welcome our friends, members of St. Mark's, friends of St. Mark's, visitors, and just our global community from wherever anyone might be joining us tonight. We are so excited for this 1.5 hour of celebrating God and just calling on the name of God and the name of God's Son, Jesus Christ, and the name of God's Holy Spirit. It's so amazing. It's amazing. The Bible says that when we call upon the name of God, something good happens.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, when we call upon the name of the Lord, something extraordinary
has
taken place in our life. You know, I personally have millions of testimonies about the things that God have done in my life through prayer. I'm not just saying this because I'm a pastor or what. I am just talking as a Christian. I have seen God at work in my own life, in the life of my friends and family, in the lives of my church family. God is real. And call upon the name of God, something happens. It may take some time because we know that God operates on God's own time,
Amen.
Not on our schedule. But Amen. Every prayer we send God's way, God hears it and God receives and acts on those prayers. Amen. And so I am very encouraged by all of you who have joined in. And those of us who will only have the opportunity to watch this prayer session later on the YouTube and on Facebook because of work reasons and any other. And so, you know, we want you to be assured that God is in our midst and God is busy doing something great and wonderful and awesome.
Yes.
For you and your family, and for
Amen.
Our faith communities, and for our communities at large. I am reminded about one person of prayer who was just faithful in prayer. And now God looked down and God saw that one faithful person and said, you know what, I may be angry and all of that, but the prayers of one person of faith are going to save the entire generation. And if you read your Bible, it is filled with stories of testimonies of occasion in which God saved the entire village just because of one person's prayer. We had a story about a young prophet, Jonah, who was sent to deliver a message inviting the people to repent from their sin and be on their knees in prayer, so that God could rescue them and save them from God's own anger. And this preacher went, first he resisted the trip, tried to be rebellious, went on a wrong ship to a different destination, but God found a way to take the messenger to the right crowd. And when Jonah got there to that city, he was preaching to them, but with anger in his heart. In other words, he was trying to act like he was some kind of God himself. He was being too judgmental to the people, judging them as people who did not deserve the mercies of God. And so he still preached the message of repentance. And to his surprise, the people heard the message. They paid attention. They were touched by it, all the way to the rulers of the city, all the mayors and the governors and all these important people, religious people. They all listened and they repent in such a way that their repentance touched the heart of God. And God decided to change the punishment and to save them instead, to deliver them instead of punishing them by death. And so, you know, it takes one person sometimes, one person of faith, or a small group. Just like Jesus said that we, the people of faith, Jesus said, we are like the salt, you know? The salt is never the majority on the food. It's a little tiny minority, but it seasons the entire food and gives taste. So we may not be a huge crowd, but the majority are always in the outdoors of faith. So we may be the minority, but don't you be discouraged and don't you undermine your power, the power that you have when you are using the name of God to pray for people of God. And so, you know, in spite of the what Jesus said, that the road that goes to salvation is always narrow, because the larger crowd is going to the large avenues and they're following the wrong route. And so the road is narrow, we know that. And the crowd on the in is always a minority. We know that too. And sometimes it's just you alone, but it doesn't matter. You still have a tremendous power in your hands. When you use your voice to pray, use your heart and your mind in meditation, asking God's favor to change, to improve, and to better somebody's life and somebody's condition. And so, my friends, that's just a general opening welcome statement to encourage you that what we are starting tonight is not something small. It's really big. It has a big impact. We have the power tonight and tomorrow night and the day after tomorrow night to really change the heart of New York and the heart of America and the heart of the world because of our prayers. God listens to our prayers. Yes, we are sinners and we are wicked. We are broken in many ways. We are not righteous and perfect. But God has made us holy in spite of all of that through the sacrifice of God's Son, Jesus Christ. God has made us holy. The forgiveness of sins is real. And so we are meeting tonight, not just as ordinary people. No, we are saints tonight. We are redeemed by the blood of Christ. And we are holy in the name of Jesus. And Amen. So we use that holiness and we will use the power that we draw from the throne of God to proclaim healing to our family members who need healing, to our friends at the church who need healing, to members in our community who need healing, to different issues in our society, in our country, and in our world that needs God's healing. So when I talk healing, I'm not just focusing on physical healing for physical illnesses of the body. I'm talking healing in every aspect of our life, mental, physical, emotional, in terms of the ills of the society and every area of our human life. We need healing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And you made time to join in tonight to just claim and raise your voice to God for healing. So I'm gonna ask for our music to come up, and after the music, after the first song, I will give you a brief reflection on First Chronicles chapter 16, verses 28 and 29. First Chronicles chapter 16, two verses, 28 and 29. I will read and give a brief reflection about those scriptures after this song that is coming up.
Thank you.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. First Chronicles chapter 16, verses 28 and 29. It reads, "Tell everyone of every nation, praise the glorious power of the Lord. He is wonderful. Praise him and bring an offering into his temple. Worship the Lord, majestic and holy." Another translation says, "Ascribe to the Lord. Ascribe to the Lord. All you families of nations, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name, and bring an offering and come before him." Oh my Lord, beautiful are the words of the Lord. If we can really tell everybody in the nations, around the nations of the globe, about the praises and the glories due to the power of the Lord, and if we can proclaim how wonderful, because hey, God is wonderful.
Amen.
God didn't have to do anything for me this day, but God did. Woke me up in the morning. I felt my energy level was intact. I was able to move around and do the things and think about this holy moment tonight with the holy people of God. God is glorious. And when I look at your faces, even just at the names of those that I can't see their faces, when I see the names, I can picture the faces on my mind. I see the glory of God. Because each one of us represent the wonders of God in our lives. And so, my friend, as we prepare to the prayer focus for this day, on day one, is God's mercy and justice. And we have three of our siblings in Christ who are going to intercede on our behalf and on behalf of the people of God in prayer. You will hear their voices, their sister Olivia Edwards. In due time, I will call upon her. And at that time, she will offer specific prayer for children going back to school and children who have already been back in colleges. And so we know the fears as parents, as family. We know the terror that has been brought in our midst by this COVID-19. Mm-hmm. And we are in the middle of a debate, a controversy. There are those who say, no, the kids should not go back to in-person classes yet. We should continue for online. And there are those in a position of decision-making who say, no, I think it's time to let the kids go back for in-person classes. And so when I dropped my daughter at school, she's 12 years old, excited about seventh grade. I dropped her in school for her first class on Monday. She had her mask and all of that. And on my way home, I was like, oh Lord, please have mercy on these kids. Keep the principal safe. Yeah. Keep the staff. We don't want any COVID in our school. I was saying those prayers, driving myself home. So we are all anxious about whether or not the children should go back to school. So we are going to invite, after the second song, you will hear the voice of Sister Olivia Edwards to offer prayers after this coming song. Thank you.
come to you to receive the food of your holy word. Take your truth, plant it deep in us, shape and fashion us in your likeness, that the light of Christ might be seen today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, and fulfill in us all your purposes for your glory.
Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Good night, everyone. I'm asking you as I pray to call your kids' names out as I pray. You pray for your kids by name. I'm praying for my children and my grandchildren and all the children of this world. But I want you also to mention your kids' names as we pray that are in school. So let us go to God and pray. Heavenly Father, for all the children returning to school or have already returned to school, send your Holy Spirit as the guide and protector. Protect them, Lord, from this COVID-19 disease as they fear to go back to school, Lord. And as we are not certain if they're going to remain in school or not. But Father God, we know that everything is with you and that you know all. And so, Father God, we are trusting you tonight. We come before you trusting you that all will be well. Keep them free from danger and unnecessary harm. Put our sons and daughters in the right place at the right time to receive your grace. Let them learn and grow strong. May the presence of your Holy Spirit fill their hearts and not fear that we are constantly hearing in the news about having another strand of COVID-19 that is worse, Lord. Help the children not to fear, but fill their hearts with your Spirit. May your Spirit cover them. Help us as parents and caregivers to do the right thing for our kids and by our kids. Help them to be respectful to their teachers and those who are in authority over them. Bless each family, O Lord. We entrust our children to you, dear God. Since from the beginning of time, they are yours to keep. And so, Father God, we give them back to you at this moment, asking you, Lord God, to cover them, Lord Jesus. Cover them as they go out and as they come in. Lord, we know that there is so much evil out there and there's so many things against these young people, Lord God. We know that the devil is trying to get at them in all kinds of ways and in all different situations. They're hearing the voices telling them to do what is not right, Lord God. But we know that there is a voice that tells them what is right. So, Father God, we are asking you to intervene for our children today, Lord God. We are asking you to cover each and every child from the beginning of, from one corner of the earth to the other corner of the earth, from south to north, from east to west, the entire world, Lord God. We are praying for all our children. We are praying for the ones that have been abused, Lord God, that you will send someone, Father God, to take them out of the abuser situation. Father God, as they continue to go to school, we ask that you will continue, Lord God, to watch over them. Continue to give them knowledge, Lord, that they would learn what they're being taught. Father God, help them as they continue to strive to do well in school. Father, we pray, Lord God, that all these things that we are asking for our kids and all these things that we are praying over our kids and all these things that we are bringing to the throne of the cross for our kids, Lord God, that you would hear our prayer tonight, Lord. Let our cry come unto you and keep our kids safe from harm. Father God, we ask all this through your Son, Jesus Christ, who said, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. So we want to say in the name of Jesus tonight, we pray protection over each and every child this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so very much. Now, after the next song, we are going to pray for the pandemic recovery. We need God's intervention to help us recover from this pandemic. The pandemic has paralyzed our lives in so many ways. The pandemic has claimed innocent lives of children, of women, of men, of our elderly, and we need divine intervention to help our human effort, medically speaking, to deliver our globe from this evil virus that is in our midst. And so that prayer will be brought to us, including, it will be brought to us by Sister Norma Fisher, And she will also pray for the victims of COVID-19, those who lost their lives, and those who are still struggling with COVID infection in hospitals, even in their homes. And so after this coming song, you will hear the voice of our own Norma Fisher blessing our souls with prayer around the issue of the pandemic.
There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. And I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you. There is none like you. There is none like you. There's no one else. No one else can touch my heart like you do. And I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like. Your mercy flows like a river so wide, and healing comes from your hand.
And suffering children are safe in your arms.
There is none like you.
Sister Norma Fisher will pray for us. Sister Norma Fisher, if you are online, just remember to unmute yourself so we can hear you. I assume that Sister Norma is probably having a connection problem. Are you there, Sister Norma? So I will take her place and offer this prayer for the pandemic Let us pray. Oh, Father God Almighty, God who is our heaven.
Can you hear me now?
Yes. Oh, yes, we can hear you. Go ahead.
Okay. I had to unmute with the star six.
All right.
Yeah. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you.
Okay.
Let us pray. Through all the changing scenes of life, in trouble and in joy, the praises of my God shall still my heart and tongue employ. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. With me exalt his name. When in distress to him I call, he to my rescue came. Almighty and ever wise God, we approach your throne of mercy where we will find grace. We come before you, O God, because we know that you are the God of all gods, and beside you there is no other. So we come out of the deep crying, Abba, Father, hear our humble cry. And while on others thou art calling, Lord, do not pass us by, because we come, because we know that you are God and God alone, and beside you, Lord, there is no other God. We come, O God, intervening on behalf of this pandemic that is stirring up so much confusion and distrust and stuff like that. But God, you know it all. But we believe and we truly understand that you're a God who sits high and you look low. You know all that is happening here below. But we gather around the throne tonight, O God of grace and mercy, because we know that you're a great and merciful God. You hear the cry of your children. You see what is happening to your people here below. But we ask you as we gather around this throne tonight, O God, you will break up the fallowness of our hearts, that our hearts may be open and inclined unto your wisdom, O God, that we will not cease to pray. We will not cease to seek you first. The word tells us, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and then you will add all other things unto us. So help us, O God, as we hold on to your unchanging arms tonight, O Lord, that it will not be, the prayer will not be for tonight alone, but we will continue to lift your name up, because we know that you are God who made all things, and you created everything, O God. You brought us together, Lord, for a reason, purpose like this. So in Jesus' name, we ask you, Lord, help us to continue on this road that we are traveling. The word of prayer. Prayer, you answer prayers, O God. And prayer is comely to the soul. We pray for the pandemic. We know that you have touched the hearts of many. We know that you are working with the first offender, for those that are there in front, O God. Those that are nurses and doctors and everything, but we ask you to keep them covered under the blood of Jesus, Lord, amen, that they will be able to work with your people here below, O God. Help them, O Father, as you work on this pandemic. We are not afraid because we know that you can do all things and you hear the cry of your people. So we're crying on to you, Lord. Hear our humble cry. We bring those that have lost, we have lost, O God, during the pandemic. Those that are still struggling. We know your son walked this earth. You know, we know that, we remember your son did a lot of healing, O God. He made the lame to walk. He made the blind to see, the deaf to hear, even the dumb to speak, O God. Help us, Father, as we continue to put our trust in you and you alone, because you are our God and beside you there is no other God. We thank you, Lord, and we ask you to help us to continue in this spirit tonight, O Father, and tomorrow night, and the night after, and forever, O God, because you like to hear your children pray. In Jesus' name I say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. All this I ask in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And now after this upcoming song, we are going to pray for social justice. We will pray for other concerns that include, but not limited to racism, issues of ageism, issues of sexism, and all those kinds of injustices that affect us personally, affect our families and our society, not only here in America, but really around the world. So after this upcoming song, you will hear the voice of our sister Dawn Stephenson, who will offer those prayers on behalf of the people of God.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Awesome, all-powerful God, we come to praise you, adore, magnify, and glorify you, for you are great and greatly to be praised. We come to you, Heavenly Father, because you bid us come unto you. You made a way of salvation for us through the atoning blood of Jesus Christ, gave us salvation, a high priest, whereby we can call out Abba God. We acknowledge you to be the answer to our prayers, who makes blossoms in the dust and rivers in the desert for your people. You part waters for us. You are the lifter up of our heads. And when we are weak, you give us strength. Who is a God like unto our God? There is no other God besides you.
and it is to you that we lift up our worship. Almighty God, we are so grateful to you for the connection that we have with you through prayer, and that we can make intercession for others, and the faith that we have to believe that whatever we pray for in the matchless name of Jesus, we will receive. So we stand on your promises as intercessors for social justice. Lord God, we bring to you the poor, marginalized, despised, forsaken, abused, those who are experiencing home instability and the ravages of natural disasters. Your word tells us to pray without ceasing. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to help us to be the bold voice of those who cannot speak for themselves, to defend the cause of the neglected and the poor, to help shed light on those who are being abused in different forms. All-powerful God, we ask you to help us to do what we can to help to rescue and to bring restoration for those who are experiencing economic reversals due to prolonged existence of COVID-19. Adonai, you are master and king of the universe. You are in charge of everything. We pray for a revival in the world, that humanity would turn from their ungodly ways and heed to the word that tells us that you are holy, that we are to be holy as the Lord God Almighty is holy. We thank you for helping us to live in accordance with what you tell us and to follow your precepts, and that we would honor the aged, because you tell us that it is a blessing to live to old age. So let us remember that, Lord God, and when we see the elderly, that we treat them with the respect that they deserve, because they are blessed by you, Lord God. And not everyone gets the blessing to be called an aged person. So help us to always to remember them in our prayers and in our actions, and let us be godly and help them in whatever ways that we can. Oh Lord, you are our helper from the past, present, and the future. I pray, speak, and declare that we will experience a divine shift in this world as people realize that they have to answer to you, for you are their creator. Father God, we intercede on behalf of those who are confused about their sexuality and are following a dark path that separates them from what your word declares. We pray that you would prick their conscience, that you would help them to turn to the counsel of God and repent of their sins. We call upon you, King Jesus, to deliver lost souls who are in need of a savior. Please touch the hearts and minds of our leaders, that as they lead, they will lead with godliness and integrity, and to remember that we were all created in your image, Lord God, and that we are all from one family, that there's to be no isms and schisms, that they're to treat everyone the same because we are from the same Father. We humbly ask that your precious will be done for the petitions that have been lifted during this prayer service. We thank you and we praise you, King Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit. We decree and declare, according to your word, that whatsoever we bind on earth is bound in heaven, and whatsoever we loose on earth is loosed in heaven. So we believe that strongholds of deception, sickness, insufficiency, and any kind of lack is being shattered now in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
And we declare the victory in no other name but the almighty and all powerful name of Jesus. And we believe and say thank you. Glory.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank Amen. You very much. And so now we have come to a time when we will continue to pray for different other topics, and also the prayers of your heart that you have brought with you tonight. They will not, you will not go back home with your prayers unattended. And so I will ask that you unmute yourself and let us know what prayers do you bring in your heart so that we can pray for those as well. If you feel comfortable texting your specific prayer concern on the chat, you can do that as well. You have the chat capability there to type your prayer. I have shut down my phone because of interference. My phone is connected to the computer screen, and I'm trying to cut down on those pop-ups on the screen. And so, but if you prefer to text me your prayer concern privately, feel free to do that. You have my number. In case you don't have it, it is 646, I repeat, 646-321, I repeat, 321. The last four digits is 7868. I repeat, 7868. So the entire number is 646-321-7868. You can text me privately your prayer concerns, and I will address those within these 3 days of prayer that we have. You should not keep silent if you have prayer that you are holding in your heart for the people of God to pray about. And so the number that I just read out, it's also on the chat, so you can see it there. You can text me your private prayer if it is private. Amen?
Amen.
So is there anyone who would like to share a public prayer request? If not, go ahead and text it. Meanwhile, I would like us to also think about and pray for the people who are going through difficult times in their relationships. Relationships amongst siblings, sisters and brothers, relationships amongst fiancés, boyfriends and girlfriends, difficult relationships amongst married couples, challenging relationships between parents and children, grandparents and grandchildren. So any issues of relationships at workplace, in schools, even in our places of worship. So relationships is the topic. So I am keeping quiet for a little while, just in case someone might want to unmute self and share a prayer request.
I'm just asking that we continue to pray for the children, because in days past, children wouldn't know about sexuality, that they can change their sex. Mm-hmm. And have a desire to change from a boy to a girl. And that happened in the class today, that a child actually was proud to announce that what they were. So I'm just asking that we keep those children covered in prayer, because mm-hmm. something strange is happening in the world today. So
yeah,
just ask that you
Amen.
Continue the prayer that we have started for children.
Okay. Thank you. Do we have any other specific prayer concerns? I see a request for prayers for the family, for the uncle, the family of the uncle of our sister, our former lay leader, Yvonne King. And so let us remember that. And also a request for prayers to our sister Odeli, and all of our seniors at the church. Sister Odeli, along with all of our seniors at the church.
I want to ask a special prayer for the healing of my grandson. He got a torn ligament in his foot when he went to camp, and it doesn't seem to be getting any better, and he's having quite a rough time trying to go back to school on crutches. So I just need to pray healing over him. Mm-hmm. Daniel.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. So we're going to add that also to all the sick and shut in. Amen. So continue to share prayers on the chat as you feel compelled to do that, so that the body can continue to pray for that.
I also want to let us lift up Guyana in prayer because of the situation that happened today in Guyana. Want to lift up Guyana in prayer. The cop shooting the guy at home. So we need to lift up Diana and pray.
Okay, let us pray for the concerns so far raised. Sister Olivia, I couldn't note down the previous prayer that you mentioned.
For Guyana?
Before Guyana.
For my grandson, Daniel.
Okay.
A healing for him.
Okay, Daniel. All right, so let us pause in prayer. And as we pray, please pray in your heart. As well. Let's pray in your heart as well. Let us pray. Our God and our Redeemer, our beginning and the end, Alpha and Omega, the Creator, the Sustainer of the creation, the source of our strength, the source of our lives, our heavenly parent, the one who truly cares, one who loves us unconditionally, not because we are perfect, not because we always do the right thing and say the right thing and have always the right attitude, but you always love us in spite of and regardless of anything. Our God, who does not favor people on the basis of the color of our skin or the country or island we were born in, but favors us all the same way, loves us all the same way. God, who is all embracing of all people, a God who considers us the same way, whether we are still little children or older people. A God who walks with us in all seasons of our lives. A God who is forever present with us in our journey of life. When we are on the right track and when we are lost, you are still our God and you are still our loving parent. We come to you now to bring our concerns about our broken relationships between our love affairs, in marriages, in relationships, when we fail each other, disappoint one another, betray one another, causing the breakage of the relationships. We bring that concern unto you right now. Somewhere, oh Lord, in this city, somewhere in our own community, right here in Brooklyn, New York City, somewhere, Lord, in this America, somewhere in this world, someone has stopped talking to another person. Someone have stopped relating to someone else because of something that went wrong, that has hurt and has crushed the relationship. We pray for restoration where possible, because we know that in you, Lord, everything is possible. We pray that relationships that have been broken will be mended, that reconciliation and peace will be possible, so that your people can live in peace, that someone can feel excited to say, I'm going back home now. It is the end of the day. I'm going home and feeling excited to go home because the people who are at home, somebody who is at home, will welcome such with excitement and joy. Lord, we pray for the family of Sister Yvonne King, specifically her uncle and the family, close family members of her uncle back home. We pray that, Lord, you will provide the comfort that is needed. You will provide for the healing of the souls that is needed. You will provide for the healing of the hearts that are mourning and broken. We pray, oh Lord, for the sick and shut in, our own members of St. Mark's. We are not going to mention the names because we are afraid, Lord, we might forget some names and hurt feelings. And we are confident that you know all the names of those who are in need of physical healing. And so, Lord, hear our prayers tonight and reach out in ways that only you can to touch the bodies and the hearts of those who are in need of healing, whether they are in hospital, in nursing homes, whether they are in their own homes and dwellings. We pray that tonight as we pray, you will reach out unto them to touch their bodies, to provide restoration and healing. For you are a God who is filled with healing powers. Lord, tonight we pray for this young man, Daniel, that has been brought and mentioned in this prayer session. Lord, we will not bother you with details because we know that you are a God who knows everything behind his name. And so we pray for your special favor for Daniel. Touch him, straighten what needs to be straightened in his life. We pray, oh Lord, for Guyana tonight. Whatever it's wrong that is taking place in Guyana, whatever the events that are affecting the people of Guyana, We pray tonight in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, that your favor, Lord, will be directed to Guyana as we mention the name of this place tonight. O Lord God, God of mercy, God of favor, hear our prayers in the name of Jesus the Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Now we do have a little more than 15 minutes, so we will continue to give opportunity to those who are holding on to prayer concerns in your hearts. I'm going to turn on my phone just in case someone might have texted me prayer concerns in privacy. So I have a prayer request from Brother Neverson. And so the names that we are praying for, Mr. Michael Dorsey of Stafford, I believe it's Virginia, and Miss Alana James of Brooklyn. And so I will not publish the specifics just in case that is to be kept confidential. Just pray for those names on your heart and lift up the name of Michael Dorsey. And please lift up in your heart the name of Miss Alana James in their health struggle. That God, who is merciful, will touch them and provide for healing, because God is merciful. God is kind. I'm just going to write down on my paper these names. Michael Dorsey. Alana James. And I have another request from my friend Claudia Gordon. She has a prayer concern for her nephew. So please remember to pray in your heart for the nephew of Sister Claudia Gordon. And I will also ask you to pray for Sister Claudia herself. I'm just making a note on my paper here. Remember to also intercede for Sister Claudia Gordon in your meditation tonight. Amen. So we will continue. Let them check on the chat. Do we have any prayers on the chat? No. Okay. If anyone wants to voice up prayers, just remember to unmute yourself and just share your prayer request. We have one prayer on the chat. Yes, we are praying for, remember to lift up the people who live on shelters. Just lift up all the people who live on shelters as well as the people who are homeless. They have no place that they call home of their own. And we want to lift them up so that the Lord can keep them safe and just provide for their needs wherever they rest every night. We see them on the subways, they are on subway stations, they are on different corners of the buildings. You know, they are people just like us. Just because they have nowhere they call home, it does not reduce or diminish any of their humanity at all. These are precious children of God. Mm-hmm. And as people of God gathered in prayer tonight, we are to remember them and pray for their needs so that God can look after them and continue to watch over them for their health and for their needs to be met. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. So let's take another moment in prayer. Right now, we will focus our prayers on this name, Michael Dorsey. Michael Dorsey. And just focus your mind and your heart on Michael Dorsey. Father God Almighty, we bring the name Dorsey, Michael Dorsey. You know the background, you know the story, you know what's going on. We pray for Michael Dorsey and we lift up Michael Dorsey unto your caring hands, your healing hands, your loving hands, and your fixing hands, Michael Dorsey. Let us all say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I believe I have received more prayers, more prayer requests. Okay, I'm just checking. Okay, so I have a prayer request from my friend Myrna Woolcock. She is requesting prayers. For her granddaughter. So this is the granddaughter. Granddaughter of Sister Myrna. Sister Myrna Woolcock. All right. Okay. So I'm going to invite us to focus our meditation and prayer to this name, Alana James. Alana James. Just lift up that name, Alana James, in prayer. Amen. O God, our beginning and our end, a God who is always attentive to listen to us, God who wants us to be in communication with you, a God who wants us to be in close relationship with you, a God who wants us not to feel shy or intimidated, to come unto you, to talk to you, and to present to you our complaints. We bring the name of Alana James right now. Lord, we ask your favor upon Alana James. Lord, we ask you to raise your hand towards Alana James. We ask you, Lord, to say a word towards Alana James to fix what needs to be fixed in her life. In the name of your Holy Son, Jesus the Christ, our Savior. Amen. Okay. Let me see if I have any new requests. Okay, so now I'm gonna ask the body of Christ to focus our attention and to direct our meditation and prayers to the nephew of Sister Claudia Gordon. Let us lift up the nephew of Sister Claudia Gordon. Don't worry, God knows which one of those nephews. Yes. Just focus your meditation to the nephew of Sister Claudia Gordon. And remember to also pray for Claudia Gordon herself. Let us pray. In the name of God, the creator of heavens and earth, in the name of you and your son, Jesus, who is Christ, in the name of Jesus, the Christ, we pray for the nephew of Sister Claudia. Lord, we bring this nephew unto your hands. We plead with you, O Lord, out of your mercy, out of your power, out of your own will, not because we pray, but because of your own will. Your will is holy. You desire for us to be well. You desire for us to be healed. You desire for us, Lord, to be transformed, to be improved on our human condition, on our physical health, our spiritual, emotional, and mental health. Your desire for us, Lord, is to be well. And so we pray in the name of Jesus right now, on behalf of the nephew of Sister Claudia, that may he find healing. Yes. In the name of Jesus. May he find everything that is right and perfect and good for his life.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Oh God Almighty, we pray for our own Sister Claudia Gordon.
Yes.
Lord, we surrender her unto your healing hands. Yes. Sister Claudia, tonight will be her yes. night of favor. Yes. This night, Lord, is the night of Claudia Gordon.
Yes.
As we lift her up unto your hands, Lord yes. Jesus yes. Christ, Lord of favor, God yes. of power and mighty, Jesus. Sister Claudia Gordon will yes. find your favor on this night,
yes,
not tomorrow, but tonight. Yes. Lord, she will find relief in her yes. health. She Jesus. Will find relief and restoration.
Yes.
Of her own health. She will find a new joy tonight as she finds herself restored in the name of Jesus. Lord, fix what needs to be fixed in her life and in the life of her family. For you are a God of mercy, a God of compassion, a God who does not turn down anybody who comes to you for a favor, comes to you for a healing. Lord, hear our prayer. And let us all repeat, Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Amen. Jesus. Amen. Okay. And so, okay. So, let us now gather our thoughts and our minds towards all of our sisters and brothers, our friends, our siblings in the Lord who live in different places, in challenging places, just because they have no place they call home. They wander from one corner to another corner, from one spot to another spot. And because of that, they are living a style. There are people who abuse them, who insult them, who take advantage of them, who assault them, and who look down upon them and make them feel like they are less than human beings. So I want us to center, let us center our minds, let us gather our hearts together and intercede for them. Send a huge blessing their way tonight. At the same time, let us remember to lift up the granddaughter of Sister Myrna Woolcock. And remember, as we do that, remember that Sister Myrna Woolcock, she is a living miracle from God herself. Considering what she has gone through, you know, and she continues to recover. She comes to church and she continues to minister in spite of everything that she has gone through, and continues to recover. And so our Sister Myrna Woolcock is a living miracle, a living testimony of God's miraculous answering of our prayers. And so let us center our minds to our granddaughter as we pray for those who are in shelters. Let us pray. In the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, a triune God who cannot be separated, a triune God who knows no division, knows no selfish spirit, a God who is three persons, but in a perfect union, in perfect relationship amongst God's self. In the name of the living God, the God of our ancestors, the God who cares for the spirit of those and the souls of those who have left this world of the living, a God who at the same time cares for us, who still walk the streets of the city, of the village, the streets and the roads, paved and unpaved, a God who cares for us all. We pray for the our siblings who live on shelters and those who are completely homeless. Their situations, their conditions do not allow them to live anywhere else, but on the trains, on the train stations, on different corners, we see them when we walk around, when we drive by. We pray for them because we know that God, they are also your daughters. They are also your sons. They are also your precious children. We pray for them that, Lord, you will continue to find a way to keep them going, to care for them, to protect them, to give them safety, and to give them health. We pray for them that, Lord, they will have something to eat and something to drink, something to put and to cover their bodies, something to give them joy, to give them hope. We pray, oh Lord, at the same time for the granddaughter of our own, Sister Myrna Woolcock, the one that you have made a living miracle in our midst. She strengthened our faith when we look at her every time, knowing the health challenges that she has to go through. And so, Lord, we pray that her granddaughter will find your mercy, will find your mercy tonight, and will find your favor tonight in whatsoever she is going through. We pray that, Lord, you are powerful. You are powerful healing and miraculous workings of your Holy Spirit will reach out to her to change her life for better. Lord, to bring healing into her health and to make her path something better, and to give her hope and joy, and to make the life wealthy to be living. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. And so now, after this last song, we will receive our benediction and we will call this day and we will look forward for tomorrow. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let us enjoy this song as we prepare to receive the benediction. Receive the benediction. This is your blessing for tonight. God, our creator, God who loved us even before we knew who you were, I ask your blessings tonight for those who have blessed others in prayer, all of us. Bless the family of Cynthia Nita. Bless the family of your child, and the phone number ends with 4439. And your child whose phone number ends with the number 3755. Bless them and bless their family. Bless the family of Myrna Woolcock. Bless the family of Olivia Edwards. Bless the family of Yvonne Graham. Bless the family of the participant who is on Galaxy S21 Ultra 5G. Hallelujah. Bless the family of Fatima Quissico. Bless the family of Marjorie Sutton. Hallelujah. Bless the family of Janelle Gale.
Hallelujah.
Bless the family of Yolande Haynes.
Hallelujah.
Bless the family of Gregory Ross.
Hallelujah.
Bless the family of Ines.
Yes,
bless
Jesus.
The family of Claudia Gordon.
Yes, Lord.
Bless the family of participant who is using Galaxy A10E. Bless the family of George Brown.
Yes.
Bless the family of Oscar Stephenson.
Yes.
Bless the family of the participant who is on Call In User One. Bless the family, Lord, of the participant whose number ends with 3010.
Yes.
Bless the family of the participant whose phone number ends with 1627.
Yes.
Bless the family, oh Lord, of the participant whose number ends on 1494.
Yes.
I pray for your special blessings tonight. For the participant whose number ends with the number 73622. I pray for your special blessings, Lord, to the family of the participant whose number ends with the number 7059. I pray for special anointing and blessing to the family whose number ends with the number 4901.
Yes, Jesus.
And I pray for a special touch,
yes,
a special
Lord.
Blessing
yes.
to the participant and the family whose number ends with the number 8301.
Yes,
for God of power,
yes,
God almighty, God
yes.
of love unconditional,
mm-hmm.
I pray for a special yes. anointing to
yes.
every family member that
yes.
is hearing my voice. All
yes.
those whose numbers are not on the screen of my computer and whose
yes.
names do not show up on the screen of my computer, I
mm.
bless them tonight in the name
Jesus.
Of God the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Amen, Jesus. Amen.
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 Thank you. Thank
Amen.
You. Thank you, everyone, for joining. I will mm. see you tomorrow. Do not be late. Try to log in before 7 p.m. Try to log in a little before 7 p.m. so that you do not have to miss any of the blessings that God gives us. Good
Amen.
Night. I will
Amen.
See you tomorrow. Thank you, Minister Janelle Gale.
Good night,
thank you, Sister Yolande Hain, for your
Thank
technical
you.
Support tonight.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Good night to you too. Have a good night.
Thank you. Good night. Good night.
Good night.